So what exactly is self? So first of all, self is a keyword that isn't strongly enforced. So for example, I can say local self equals hello world. And it works perfectly fine. But like if I were to try local for equals hi or something, it yells at me because for is a like really high level keyword. Whereas self is more syntactical sugar. So you can treat a self variable saying local self as any other variable. So I can print self, whatever. And it works. But that's not when you see self usually. Usually it's in a function body. And that's what its main purpose is for. So let me give you an example. So we have a, let's just have a module. I know this is not a module script, but you can pretend with me. And we can make a function module dot do something. And this will take in a number, and it'll just print number plus one. And we can just try module do something with a number of like two or something. If we run this, you see we get three. That's exactly what we want. But what if we were to change the module do something into module colon do something? Now, if we were to run this, what would happen is this would error. Because we tried to add on nil a number. You may be asking, well, there's a number here, and we're sending a number, but the colon means everything. So what happens is the number that we send in is shifted to the variable self. So if we were to print self right above our num plus one, I'm actually going to comment this out so it doesn't error. If we just print self, you can see it prints two. So what happens is we say module dot do something with the value of two. It goes in and it changes itself to self because of this colon right here. Now, if we were to do what normally people do is we say module do something with both colons, which is always best practice, a different thing will happen. So the module colon do something will pass in the module. So if it prints self, it'll print a table, and this table has do something, which is a function. So it passes itself in. And really, most of the time, self is used for prototype classes in Lua, but you don't have to. It can be used in whatever situation you want in regards to functions. But let's just go through a prototype class example just for completeness sake. So I'm going to delete everything, create a class, and say local class equals a blank table, and then class underscore index equals class. Make sure to have double underscores. That's important. It's a med method. We can do function class dot new. And by the way, this is just normal object-oriented practices. If you don't know about that, I have a series on that. I'll link it right now. And inside of here, we can just say local self equals set meta table, a blank table, and then class. And you may be asking, why am I using self here? It's just because usually in a class, self is already defined, but since we're creating a new one, it just makes sense to name the variable self. Now, this is just a variable name. It has no special importance because there's no colon up here. Now, what we can do down here is just return self. So you can change this to a letter, and it would work. I just like self because it looks better, and it makes a little more sense in my head. The program doesn't really care. So now we can create a function, class, do something, once again. And then we can just print self, just to get the point across. So let's run that. We can create a class by saying local c equals class.new. And then we can do c, do something. And when we print self, it'll just print a blank table because we're setting, we made a new table, set meta table. And if we were to add something like a number like 3 and add a variable here for number, print self comma num, it'll just print our table and the number we sent. And so this brings up another good point. If you happen to have a typo, it'll lead to very interesting errors. So for example, down here, I change it to self or C dot do something. It'll lead to some interesting behaviors because self will bump back to 3 and then our actual like variable won't have anything. So if I try to kind of try to call another function on self, it'll give me a very misleading error. So if I say self dot new or something, if I wanted to make a new class, this you wouldn't really use this, but just an example. It says attempt to index number with new, and you're like, but I created a class. You have to look for these stupid errors with colons, and that's one thing just to watch out for. And one more thing, the reason you'd use self, which I know this takes me a while to get to, is to access variables in your class that were set earlier. So at the beginning of my script, I can just say self dot my num equals 3. And then if I print down here in the do something class, if I print self dot my num, it'll print 3. Well, obviously without this error. Let me fix that error real quick. And you can see it prints 3 originally. That's just because this self dot my num is putting something in our table. And you can see also in the print statement, the in between the brackets, there is my num equals 3, which is exactly what we want. And you can do the same thing for other functions and just anything you want. But I mean, that's about it. Self is a very simple keyword. You can do a lot of stuff with it, and it just makes everything a bit easier. It's syntactical sugar, meaning it doesn't actually change the functionality of any of your programs. You could indeed just write class.doSomething, and then the first parameter will be self, and the second will be number, and it'll work the exact same. But a lot of Lua programmers like to use it just because the feature's there, and you might as well. So, like the video if you enjoyed it, subscribe to my channel for more scripting content, and other than that, I hope you have a nice day, and goodbye.